Lieutenant Colonel Stu Scheller, whose career as a Marine includes duties as a platoon commander, XO of a MARSOC battalion, and commander of AITB infantry training, has been making rounds in the past couple days for videos he posted demanding accountability from military and political leaders over the American withdrawal from Afghanistan. In those videos, he says that leaders need to accept responsibility for their failures, including the deaths of 13 Americans killed in a suicide bombing in Kabul, and that he's willing to give up his entire career to bring the whole fucking system down. I think that he's wrong, and here's why. What's up, guys? Max here, back with another video. If you're new here, my name is Max, almost 14 years in the Navy, multiple deployments, including Iraq and Afghanistan. If you like military news, finding all about what's going on around the deck plate, so to speak, make sure you hit that subscribe button with notifications on. We do a live show Sunday through Thursday in the United States at 1800 Pacific Standard Time, as well as live streaming all kinds of cool stuff right here on this channel and videos coming out all the time. So let's get right into today's video without further ado. First of all, I agree with him. Leaders should be held accountable for the way the United States withdrew from Afghanistan. In fact, one of the greatest problems I believe we face today in America is a lack of accountability in our leaders. Time and time again, elected officials lie directly to our faces. They know it, we know it, and they know that we know it. Yet they do it anyway, waving a middle finger in the faces of all the citizens of our country. Lieutenant Colonel Scheller is a high-ranking Marine Corps officer, and as such, he knew what he was doing when he posted his first video in uniform criticizing senior leaders in and out of his chain of command. He was immediately relieved of his duties after posting his first video and said his leadership was doing what they needed to do. That's true. In his second video, he announced he would, in fact, give up his commission as an officer effective September 11th, 2021, forfeiting his retirement and ultimately what would be millions of dollars in benefits. So, obviously, he believes in what he's doing. The first reason I think he's wrong is that he is a leader of Marines. What are enlisted and junior officer Marines supposed to do when their leader gives up on the uniform and walks away from his command? Is that ultimately going to hurt all of his subordinates by causing them to also give up on the military, the leadership, the mission, and the core values they have sworn to uphold? After the deaths of 11 Marines, a sailor, and a soldier downrange, is that really the right time for a commander to leave his troops under any circumstances? I don't think so. The second reason is if he thinks that the military is this jacked up, that he has to bring the whole system down, as he says, then is he really able to do that more effectively outside the system rather than from within? I think that he could do far more to reshape the system through mentorship of junior officers and enlisted troops while shielding them from the staff-level pressures and politics that fall on 05 and above leaders until maybe they're ready for it. Now, he will never have a chance to teach those lessons that he learned in combat and all the other roles he held in a military environment. The third and ultimately the saddest reason is I think Stuart's about to learn that most people just don't care as much as he thinks they do. Most people at the end of the day have families and personal interests that they're going to prioritize ahead of the military and the righteous call for justice and accountability that he's making. Even though the deaths of young Americans at the hands of an ISIS suicide bomber is the reason we're having this conversation today, most will still continue to live their lives and perform their duties as they always have, rather than risk it all over this emotional response. And that's going to be a devastating realization for him if he hasn't made it already. The way that he went about this emotionally is going to push the people he needs away and attract the kind he likely doesn't need at all. On one of his LinkedIn posts, a commenter wrote, "How come all the 13 killed in Afghanistan were officers and none were enlisted?" This is actually the opposite of the truth. All who were killed were enlisted. And it makes me wonder how many of these online supporters are actually just trolls or bots or otherwise just conspiracy theorist internet addicts. Don't confuse high numbers of likes and comments with actual support. Not only that, but there are also people expressing serious disagreements with him on his social media accounts, as you can see here. He says in his video he needs the blue-collar American support, but also says he needs the support of congressmen and the Bellwether Alliance, which according to the internet is a group of business leaders, celebrities, philanthropists, and more, with a focus on making a positive impact on humanity. But I think people generally don't want to associate with such an aggressive posture like the one Stu has taken here. Lieutenant Colonel Scheller also talks about his success as an entrepreneur, and on LinkedIn, I found a business of his, The Perfect Ribbon, which is a mold that helps attach stars, leaves, battle devices, and more to military ribbons. It says the product is sold in military exchanges, but I doubt that's going to continue for long. The position that he's put himself in here as the enemy of the system is surely going to create a lot of pushback from the government, and anyone who would consider aligning themselves with him must realize that they are also putting their entire careers and livelihoods in great peril, and I doubt he'll find many influential partners willing to go public with their support. What do you all think? Do you support Lieutenant Colonel Scheller's mission? If so, are you supporting it publicly? Are you all in with him? Or do you think that the way he went about it was a mistake like I do? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. Ultimately, I hope that Lieutenant Colonel Scheller finds peace and a positive outcome in all of this. It sounds like he has honestly had a great career as a Marine up to this point and was probably well-liked and respected by his peers. I wish him nothing but the best for the rest of his life after the Marine Corps. And until next time, that's the Scuttlebutt. What's up, guys? Thanks for watching that video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and hit that subscribe button up in the corner here and check out this next video. If you want, in the description down below, there's links where you can get Scuttlebutt Show merch and find out how you can support the channel. I really appreciate it, and I look forward to talking to you guys very soon.